New this morning, some major roads in Fargo will be a little wider after a big cleanup overnight.
We spotted more than a dozen vehicles on South University Drive just before midnight. If you were out driving late last night, you maybe saw this. Crews scoop up excess snow from the sides of the road and pile it right there in the center ridge for several blocks.
Yeah, then two trucks work in tandem to pull that snow up from the ground and drop it into a dump truck. It's then hauled away to the landfill. Underneath all that snow on the roads and highways, there's a lot of ice right now. Many people wondering why. The reason is just too cold and windy.
Road crews tell us that the sand and salt often used to treat slick surfaces doesn't work well in these extreme temperatures that we've been dealing with for the past several days. And when the wind picks up, like during blizzard conditions, it also just blows the sand right there off the roadway anyway.
Yeah, we want to get a check of what you're up against this morning now when you try to head out the door. And if you have any travel plans, get a check with that with meteorologist Lisa Green.
Good morning. Yes, we are in the midst of a blizzard warning in the valley. We're looking at much of the heart of the valley included in this, stretching westward toward the Devil's Lake Basin and the Jamestown area. And if you're not in the blizzard warning, you're still dealing with some hazardous travel conditions out there, because not only do we have blowing and drifting snow happening, but it's dangerously cold. Wind chill warnings covering much of the Dakotas and westward, and a wind chill advisory in effect for northern Minnesota. So everybody's under some form of alert. Some of us multiple alerts with the cold and the wind. So let's talk about where we're at right now for visibility. It's worsened a bit as we've started the valley today. We did see some visibility reports at least staying above a mile. That's not the case anymore. In Wahpeton, we're less than a mile visibility for you. In Jamestown, under 2 miles visibility. In Fargo, we've seen it fluctuate a little bit. We've come back up again at the airport at 2.5 miles. Elbow Lake, Detroit Lakes, about 1.5 miles, 1.25 miles there for visibility for you. Crookston's less than a mile, and Grand Forks so far doing okay at about 5 miles at the airport, but that could change pretty rapidly. Can do at less than a mile visibility for you as well. So there are these pockets where it's a lot lower, and keep in mind, you know, these are at airports, at in and near communities and towns here where you're going to have more objects to kind of block that wind and help with the visibility. Out in that open country, visibility could be even worse, and that's our biggest concern with this situation is ground blizzard conditions, that blowing snow from areas where we have large amounts of it and big open areas. Here's a look at our wind, gusting to 37 miles per hour in Bedette, 32 in Hallock, wind coming in out of the northwest. Southern Valley, a little bit stronger. Fergus Falls checking in with a wind gust of 40 miles per hour, 32 miles per hour in Fargo. So again, we're getting into that range where we would be more and more concerned about blizzard conditions. You can see our camera shaking here at Luther Family Ford in Fargo, and from time to time, that gust will pick up some snow and blow it, and you can see it illuminated in the lights there at the lot. And you can see it's also somewhat okay in town. It's once you get out of town where we really see those hazards. So don't let that fool you. If you step outside or look out the window and think, oh, it's okay, travel should be fine, that's not necessarily the case here once you hit the roads. Here's a look at our current conditions. Temperatures are very cold. Moorhead, 11 below your current temperature, but it feels like 40 below. It feels like 42 below in Fergus Falls with a air temperature of 11 below. So dangerous, life-threatening wind chills here yet again today. With no snow coming down, it's just blowing around across our views here as we're trying to get to where we need to be. So you can see it's pretty quiet in the tri-state area, again, for accumulating snow, but that doesn't really tell the picture of the blowing snow on those radar maps. And temperatures again today, below zero. Winds are going to be intense all day long. We're looking at gusts likely lasting into the 40s into the nighttime hours tonight, easing up overnight and into Saturday. Though Saturday travel won't be perfect. We're looking at still some breezy weather for anybody traveling on Saturday, especially into Minnesota, closer to that departing low. And then Sunday, we'll have to watch out for a little bit of fresh snow. A clipper sweeps through at the tail end of this event. So several days leading up to and into the holiday where travel is going to be tough.
All right, it's been a tough week with these temperatures, and an even tougher week if you have to travel. Let's hop right on over to Jordan and see how those road conditions are turning out.
That's for sure. It's going to be a tough day if you have to travel. In fact, some roads you can't even travel on. Right now, what we are looking at with most of the state of North Dakota, kind of this U-shape is outlined in the counties in red. That is because no travel is advised there. The DOT is saying you should stay off of these roads. One little area of North Dakota in a travel alert, that's from Devil's Lake to Minot North. So this stretch right here, the upper north central part of the state, is in a travel alert. That means you still can travel. However, conditions can change very quickly, so you need to watch out for that. Some roads are actually closed this morning. Big ones if you have travel plans. I-94 from Jamestown into Montana is closed this morning. Highway 281 just south of Jamestown is closed this morning. Highway 52 going north of Jamestown also closed this morning. Several other roads around Dickinson closed this morning as well. Right now it looks like we have an incident in Fargo on the interstate here. You need to watch out. And then also if you look at our map, you'll see this little icon on I-29 right by the South Dakota border. That's because the interstate is closed in South Dakota. So if you're trying to head to the south on 29, you're going to get stopped at the border there. Do not go around it. You can face a fine and also put your life and other people's lives in danger as they would try to rescue you. So you need to watch out for that. Let's take a look here at what's going on in Minnesota. I just want to make sure that this is updated so we get the very latest picture on what you're up against when you head out the road to Minnesota. The southwestern portion of the state on earlier check was pretty bad. Yep, this is south of Alexandria. Right here is Wilmer. There is the Twin Cities. All of this red around Mankato. Road closed down there. Around Wilmer, fully covered roads. No travel advised down there. I-94 right now in Minnesota, if you're trying to go to the Twin Cities, is actually looking pretty decent. Just outside of Moorhead, we're talking about some partial coverage. But once you get to the Twin Cities, you need to watch out down there. We're already reporting 40-plus crashes in the Twin Cities area right now this morning. So if that's where you're planning on heading, be careful. Ashlyn? Wow.
Yeah, thank you for that updated real-time look. It's another day of canceled flights in and out of the valley, so make sure you keep your tabs on your air travel plans as well. At least 7 flights out of Hector Airfield in North Fargo are scrubbed or delayed, and there are likely to be more as the day goes on. Total flight cancellations within, into, or out of the United States today have already surpassed the total for all of yesterday. It's according to FlightAware Tracking. The number of flights around 2,700 so far this morning. And some weather experts are calling this a once-in-a-generation kind of winter storm. And our consumer alert this morning on children's weighted blankets. The Consumer Product Safety Commission and Target are recalling more than 200,000 Pillow Fort weighted blankets.
At issue, a young child can get trapped in the blankets. That poses a death risk by asphyxiation. Already happened twice. A 4-year-old girl and a 6-year-old girl reportedly became entrapped in the cover of the weighted blanket. They died from asphyxia at Camp Lejeune in North Carolina last April.
The blankets were sold exclusively at Target from December 2018 through September 2022. They were $40. If you have one at home, stop using it immediately and contact Target for your refund.
And we want to leave you this week with a look at some babies that are dressed up as Santa at Sanford Hospital. That's right behind us in this video.
Santa baby.
Oh, there we are. Hurry down the chimney tonight.
Yes.
I don't think they're going down any chimney anytime soon.
No, how
but
sweet are they?
Anyway, if you have travel plans, stay safe. Otherwise, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Happy holidays, everybody. Take care.